buddy who's in the rear, the bird back at the front of the car. As an aerodynamicist, my favorite thing is to, our thing is to work from the front, work to the, go to the rear. Wanted to thank everybody for coming. I'm definitely excited and proud to talk about the Malibu, not only because it's actually the third generation of the game that I've been able to work on, but as the aerodynamicist, I'm one of the few engineers that gets to work on the vehicle from the inception all the way through to production. And when I mean all the way through to production, we're still working on the aero of this car at this point to keep it as low as possible. The thing that we're most proud of is the improvement we've made over the current car. The current car has a drag coefficient of 0.350. We've been able to take 50 counts out to make the Malibu Eco a 0.30 drag coefficient. And that really equates to a 2.5 mile per gallon improvement in highway fuel economy if you were to drive the current car on the road. The 0.330 for the Eco and the 0.29 for the 2.5 liter engine that we have coming out next summer represents the lowest drag vehicle we have as far as mid-sized cars in the 100-year history of Chevrolet. And to put that in perspective, that gets us really close to where the base Chevrolet Corvette is, and we're approaching where the Chevrolet Volt as well at 0.28. And the big win from an aero standpoint, you look at making a car that's going to be a 2.9 or a 3.0, it really starts from the top of the program team on down. It takes a commitment from anybody who works on any part of the car that actually touches air to get a car that's this low. So there has to be a commitment from design and a commitment from the engineering team to get a car that's a 3.0 or a 2.9. And everybody stepped up, and we took a lot of work, but we were able to make it happen. And the thing that we're really proud of is not only do we have a low drag car, but we have a low drag car that's very beautiful and that will be very pleasing to the customer. With that being said, we have both design-related engineering enablers that we feel are incorporated into the design seamlessly, but we also have engineering enablers that the customer will never see. So just as a quick walkthrough from the front to the rear, we're very proud of the airflow management system we have on this vehicle. The top two grille openings are, the uppermost one is 100% blocked, and the middle one is partially blocked to allow some airflow through the bottom. So those are our passive front end airflow reduction devices, but we're also very proud of the, I probably can speak to it better over here, is the shutters in the lower grille. And we're happy about our proprietary algorithm that we have here that controls the opening and shutting of the opening and closing of the shutters based on three different parameters: vehicle speed, fan duty cycle, and ambient temperature as well. So if we're able to reduce the amount of flow that goes through the engine compartment, it's a less restriction for the flow to go around the car, so less drag impact in general. So as we look down lower below the active shutters, we do have a full underbody treatment on this car, and this display is really, really nice because it's raised. There's a mirror underneath, so you can take a look at the underbody panels. But before we get to that, I wanted to talk about the air dam. That's not only a very important styling cue for the vehicle, but hides a lot of the underbody from the oncoming flow, directs the flow around the car and accelerates it beneath it, and really makes it more aerodynamic. It's a little bit tougher to see, but when you get a chance, behind the air dam, we also have front tire deflectors. Between the tire deflectors that reduce the pressure loading on the tires and the air dam, we get about 15 counts of drag out of the front end underbody components. If you guys want to walk around, you can see we have four underbody panels. We have mid-body panels on either side of the tunnel, and then we have an underbody panel over the fuel tank and on the opposite side of the tunnel as well. So it's four total underbody panels. We're excited to have underbody panels on this car. It was an extremely big challenge to get global underbody panels put on a car that's going to be built in four different plants on multiple different programs on this architecture. And to get that done is a big deal on a mid-sized car. What else from an engineering standpoint? The one difference I wanted to point out between the 2.5 liter that we have coming out, that's the 0.29 drag coefficient, and this, which is the 0.30, is the tire size. The wheel size increases from a 16 to a 17, and the tire size goes from a 215 millimeter to a 225 millimeter. It results in a slight drag increase for the Eco because of the larger section width and potential changes in the trim height, but from an overall fuel economy balance, it's a win for the Eco. We still end up ahead, even though we give up a little bit in drag. If we circle back to this one, the blue model, the blue vehicle, I call everything a model because most of my properties are models that I work with. We can talk about some of the design features. When you start off trying to get a car that's a 0.29 or a 0.30, you need to get the basic shape of the vehicle correct to start with. And the thing that's the most important is the shape of the front corner of the vehicle. If you look at the vehicle at the front corner from plan view shape, top down, it's very important to have a parabolic shape that allows the oncoming flow to the vehicle to attach to the front end of the vehicle and then turn the corner and stay attached all the way down the body side. If you get a poorly designed front corner, you get the airflow separating, shooting off the side, and you have no luck of whatever you do down on the back side of the car, that just won't work for you. So this one part of the car, while it looks fairly simple, there was a lot of thought balancing out design requirements, aero requirements, and head pro requirements to make it work out. We had a lot of heated discussions that Gene was part of, and we feel like we have a very good looking corner that's aerodynamic as well. With that being said, moving slightly rearward, another very challenging part that we have on the car is the outside rearview mirror. This is a fixed head mirror. It's a smaller head mirror that's closer to the car, which is all good for aerodynamics. And the exciting thing is that it represents a 7-count improvement over today's car for the pair. And that's a big win. These mirrors, if you were to take the mirrors off and run it the wind tunnel, they would be worth about 9, maybe 10 counts of drag, which really equates to world-class drag performance for these mirrors. And coupled with that, it's a very quiet mirror as well. So it really contributes to the great interior noise that low levels of noise that we have. Let's see, moving rearward in car, the second thing that we look at when we do a low drag car from a basic shape standpoint is what we call the declination angle. And that's the angle from the header of the backlight to the trailing edge of the deck lid. We have, at General Motors, we have 30 plus years of aerodynamic expertise, and we know exactly what this angle should be, the horizontal. And the great thing with this vehicle is the declination angle was where it should be was identified from the studio before I even had to badger them about it. So we got a very, very good starting point from the studio. So all we had to do was very, very minor tweaks to the height, the angle, the chamfer on the deck lid, which is a big Chevrolet Q as well. So that's a very big driver in the aerodynamics of the performance of the car. And lastly, another cool design cue that we have that people may or may not know that's an aerodynamic enabler is the separation edge and the outboard edge of the tail lamp itself. It looks strictly like a design feature, but this allows for clean separation of the airflow as it's coming off the rear of the vehicle. That pretty much summarizes everything that I wanted to talk to from an aero standpoint. If anybody has any questions, please come up to me. I'd be happy to talk to you about it. We are very proud of this vehicle from an aero standpoint. Like I said, we can't get a 0.29 or a 0.30 unless the whole corporation's on board to achieve this. So I'm very very happy with the team effort that was put into this car.